guiding counsel. Before I begin, let me assure all of you, I'm unlikely to come back as guest faculty, and even if I do, I'm not going to ask you questions on my speech. So you can listen calmly and silently. Dr. Atish Chattopadhyay, Dr. John Kekna, Mr. Rakesh Nidhata, Dr. Sarita Shetty, faculty, parents, organizers of today's program, and managers of India's tomorrow. At the outset, let me congratulate the batch of 2019-21 for successfully crossing the threshold and entering the world of professional education. You will be spending your days and nights of the next 2 years in lectures, assignments, group discussions, case studies, immersion programs, as your professors strive to make you adept in business and economics and marketing and operations research. The pressure cooker atmosphere of a management school will convince you that you have seen it all, done it all. Nothing could be more challenging. Nothing can daunt you anymore. You could not be more wrong. For all its hectic pace and agitated classroom fireworks, you will, in the next 2 years, be living in a cocoon of privilege and a bubble of simulation. For all its attempts at comprehensiveness, there are aspects that management education simply fails to address. Even where it has tried to do so, and IFI has been one of the pioneers in that end, the westernized and Americanized curricula blinkers both student and the teacher. When you are enthralled with the magic of markets, it takes some independence of thought and effort of will to realize that most of your fellow countrymen have little hope of actually entering that market. I recall Hamlet's words to Horatio in Shakespeare's play The Hamlet. There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of your philosophy. This is true of our management education, in fact of most higher education in our country. What should your management education be? Should it prepare you for life in the corner office, or for life in its totality, richness and variety? Whether you will emerge from these portals as an efficient manager, a great leader, or a well-rounded human being depends mostly on you. Let me give you a few pointers to help you along your way. My first suggestion is, do a reality check every day. Many lessons that our textbooks teach us may not be valid in an Indian scenario. Ask yourself why. When I was in IIM Bangalore, good stylish packaging was all the rage. My marketing professor showed us the example of an excellent perfume that was produced by Khadi Gramodyogal. And his claim was that though the product was good, it would not sell because the packaging was extremely simple. It was sold in a simple glass bottle. It is still sold in a simple glass bottle with a small label. My contention was that the excellence of the product was more critical to attract the informed customer. regardless of the pathogen. Today, the Western world is coming around to my point of view. The marketing profession is coming around to my point of view. And in a cost-cutting scenario, over-packaging is considered superfluous and environmentally unfriendly. So, every theory that you study, cross-check it with what you know. Test it against the touchstone of actuality. Develop models that work for the Indian reality. Second, you need to prepare yourself. You need to prepare yourself to face the challenges of the working world. Whether you are new to the workplace or a seasoned employee, problems occur at work. We live, work, and study in a hyper-competitive world. We believe that the best way to get ahead is to pull down our peers. Very soon, everyone's energy is spent in safeguarding themselves or intriguing against others. When we fail, and fail we inevitably will, frustration and depression follow. Managers burn out in their early 40s. What is needed is that our work environment becomes more collaborative than competitive, with a greater acceptance of mistakes, with a consultative process of decision making, and a focus on time-tested values that our parents practiced, but we have forgotten. Hard work, contentment, persistence, self-reliance, resilience. These will stand you in good stead in the ups and downs of your career. Finally, realize that you have a greater responsibility. You are fortunate that you are here. It feels good to be a big fish in a small pond. But unless that pond is rejuvenated by your contribution, it will run dry, and fish both big and small will simply cease to exist. Give back, therefore, in any way that you can. Shramdaan for cleaning your campus, each one, volunteering for the National Social Service Scheme. There are multifarious ways in which you can simultaneously give and grow as a human being. Explore these opportunities and practice them without self-promotion or publicity. This is not for your resume, this is for yourself. Hold on to your integrity for all that you are worth. Ethics is taught in the classroom nowadays, but for you, it should go beyond into every decision that you make, every step that you take. Just three messages for you today. Do a reality check, prepare yourself for the working world, and give back to society. I have no problems with your joining the rat race. If you are truly convinced you are a rat, by all means do so. But I don't believe that you are here to become the fastest rat. I believe you are destined for greater things, to be great leaders, to be great human beings. Fulfill that promise of your greatness. Thank you all and good luck.
Thank you, ma'am, for those inspiring words. Your wisdom and advice will surely help the students make all the right choices for beyond tomorrow. We have reached the closure of